Welcome everyone, this is Coach Matic from University of Virginia. Today we're going to talk about Ethan Dubs. I want you guys to check out the practice from the other day. Ethan had one of the best practices of all time. We worked on three things. Left block, getting the straight left leg in the finish. Left arm, keeping it lower and elbow a little bit closer to the body. And keeping the right elbow higher so you can feel the full range of motion in the throw. Ethan did an impressive job in keeping all those three things in mind. And as you can see in the video, one of the throws, he was so surprised that it kind of threw him back off. I hope you guys enjoy. What we like to do before each throwing session is warm up extensively. We can't stress enough how important that is. Do a couple loops of running, some hurdles, some bands, nice. Skips, whatever you need to feel comfortable before coming onto the field and starting to pick first with two arms, then one arm, before coming onto the track and throwing a little bit more aggressively. Like I said, we cannot stress enough how important it is to warm up really well before each throwing session is in throwing the javelin. One purpose of this video also will be to show you guys how we conduct practice here at UVA. I like to take as many videos as possible or as necessary. Not every throw, but if we're working on particular things, I will take a video of as many throws as possible so the athlete can see the position of his or her body in that throw and they can adjust that a little better on the next throw. And as I said in the beginning, Ethan is working on his left block. As you can see, he's doing a little bit of drills here with his left block on his left arm and keeping his right elbow a little bit higher. So those were the three things we were focusing on in this practice. Obviously in javelin, athletes take a little bit more time between the throws than rest of the throwers, but it depends on athlete how much that is. So it might be 2 minutes, 3 minutes. I knew athletes, javelin throwers, who took as long as 10 minutes between each throw. So it all depends from person to person, but like I said, definitely more time between the throws is necessary in javelin than shot put, hammer, and discus.
Same thing.
Thank you.
As you will see on this particular throw, Ethan had his left block, his left leg, a little bit bent. So after seeing this video, Ethan adjusted that and had one of the best blocks of his life. It kind of threw him off guard, caught him by surprise, so check it out. As you will see on this throw, on his left leg, check that out. Much better job with his left leg, and very powerful finish in this throw.
It was so fast, I just wasn't ready for it.
Boom!
Yeah. Yeah.
One of it, right?
Yeah.
That's how you throw it. Good. Elbow first. Walk, elbow first. Okay, okay, good, 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 good. Nice and easy. Nice, there you go, Ethan. Good. Finish with that. How's
it? Today, just working on having a strong block and having my elbow finish to the top rather than dropping before I throw.
True.
I felt a good block today and I wasn't ready for it, but I think I'm on the track to improve.
Uh-huh. You're good.